Subject is Elements of Civil Engineering and Engineering Mechanics. Code is 18CIV14 or it may be 24. So, one problem is given. The problem statement is determine the resultant of the force system acting on a steel bracket with respect to point O, referring from the given figure. So, here the dark brown color indicates the steel bracket. The force are acting at this point as well as at this point. So, we have to replace all these forces by means of a single resultant force with respect to point O. So, by seeing the geometry of the figure, this problem comes under the Coplanar non-concurrent force system. Here, Coplanar is nothing but all the forces are lying in one plane, but their line of action of all the forces are not intersecting or not meeting at a common point. So, the earlier methods seem similar to the concurrent force system. We have to choose the convenient coordinate axis if it is not given. In the problem, it is given that the O is the reference point. With respect to reference point O, we have to find the location of the resultant R. So, for that one, as it is given, we can say that this one has X axis and this one has the Y axis. So, next thing is that we have to resolve the force into its corresponding horizontal as well as the vertical component. For that one, we need at least the angle made by the each and every force. So, before that one, go on naming the force. This one is called as the F1, F2, F3, F4. So, here the angle made by the force 200 is given as 60 degree with respect to x-axis, whereas this force is acting in the positive x-axis, this force is acting in the positive x-axis, whereas this force is acting in the inclined 4 horizontal to 3 vertical. So, before that one, first go on naming the forces, call this one as F1 force, F2, F3 as well as F4. Whereas the angle made by the first force is given as 60 degree. This one is the F2 is acting in positive x-axis. F3 is acting in positive axis. Whereas this force is 4 horizontal to 3 vertical. So, by referring the diagrammatic representation, so we can easily assess that it is a 3-4-5 method. 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 5 square method. Nothing but Pythagoras theorem. So, from that one, let us call this one as angle theta. So, that sin theta is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. Nothing but we will get that 0.6. Cos theta is equal to base divided by hypotenuse. We will get as 0.8. So, from that one, so we can convert that force into its corresponding horizontal as well as the vertical component. So, first one is the 200 cos theta. Positive x-axis 200 sin theta, the negative y-axis. This is coming in the fourth quadrant, whereas this is in positive x-axis, positive y-axis. This is coming in the fourth quadrant. Both are the negative values, minus x, minus y. So, here this one is 200 cos 60 degree. It will get that 100 newton. 200 sin 60, I will get that 173.20. Similarly, whereas this one, this horizontal component is 500 cos theta, will get as 400 newton. Whereas this one is 500 sin theta, will get as 300 newton. So, now the place transfer all the force into one tabular column. Here, I made one simple tabular column. The first one is column is force, horizontal component, vertical component. Force is written as F1, F2, F3, F4. 200 newton, 400 newton, 300 newton, 500 newton. So, it is 200 cos 60, it is positive x-axis, minus 200 sin 60, it is negative y-axis, it is in fourth quadrant. Whereas, Ft is acting positive x-axis, therefore, it is y component is 0. Similarly, F3 is y component is 300 newton, positive y-axis, therefore, x component is 0. Whereas, the force 4, 500 newton is acting in the third quadrant. Minus 500 cos theta, minus 700 sin theta, it is minus 400, minus 300 newton. So, after that one, made the algebraic summation, summation FH as well as summation FE. So, this term I am getting it as positive, this term I am getting it as negative. So, next is, I have to find the magnitude of the resultant R. So that is given by the equation under root Fa square plus Fe square. I will get around 199.99 Newton, nothing but around, say around 200 Newton. So let the angle made by the resultant R with respect to x axis be the pi. Therefore, tan pi is equal to summation Fp divided by Fh. I will get that 173.20 divided by 100. I will get around pi is equal to 60 degree. So now we have to draw the resultant diagram. So here, as it is positive x axis, negative the y axis, therefore the resultant is coming in the fourth quadrant. So I had drawn the constructed the parallelogram, and the line joining the angle diagonal itself will give the resultant R. Resultant R given like this, and the angle is 60 degree. So now I had to replace this resultant R. I had converted all the force into one component summation Fh, one component summation Fe. After that one, I had converted these two force into a single resultant force. I had to replace this resultant force about this point. So for that one, so I had to apply the Varignon's principle of moment. This is the Varignon's principle of moment. Here, that principle state that algebraic sum of moments of all forces about point O will be equal to the product of magnitude of the resultant R multiplied by its perpendicular distance, whereas D is the perpendicular distance of the resultant R from point O. So for that one, I am taking the moments of all these forces. So this is nothing but 200 into cos 60 is positive x axis. So it's the vertical distance will be the, this is the vertical distance. We'll take it like this. So 200 multiplied by 200 cos 60 multiplied by 600. Similarly, 173.20 multiplied by this distance 1.5. Similarly, 400 into 0, because it is these two forces are acting at the same point. They are not having any perpendicular distance. So there D is 0 here. These two are 0. Similarly, the fourth force is there. Fourth force is 400. So 400 into the distance is 3 meter. Similarly, the 300 into distance is 0.5 meter. So I will get, after making the computation, I will get that algebraic sum of moments of all forces about point O is equal to minus 490 Newton meter. So it indicates that, negative sign indicates that the moment is anticlockwise moment. So I had converted, so I removed the sign and shown in the symbolical representation that anticlockwise direction. So now by referring the formula, so I can directly apply the formula and find the perpendicular distance. D is equal to the algebraic sum of moments of all forces about point O divided by R. I will get that that perpendicular distance will be 2.451 meters from point O. This is very important. We are locating the distance D with respect to point O. So now the thing is that I have to transfer this resultant R, with respect to point O, so that it will be giving the anticlockwise moment. So I just slided the force here, and that perpendicular distance will be approximately measuring 2.45 meters from point O. So if I take the moment of this force about this point, nothing but, so moment M is equal to 490.2 multiply, sorry, it is 200 multiplied by 2.45, I will get that 490.20 Newton meter. So this is the problem.